sending. I know that you send me, darling, you send me. Honest you do, honest you do, honest you do. At first I thought it was infatuation, but ooh, it's lasted so long. But now I find myself wanting.
Well, Institute, they're going to go ahead and start coming in. So please give them a round of applause because they worked very hard to get here today.
But nonetheless, you have all made it to today. You should all be proud of yourselves
and very proud of all the hard work that you have put into these last 12 months. I want to congratulate each and every one of you for all of your effort and hard work which has brought you here. As you prepare to embark on a new journey in the career that you have chosen, I want you to always keep in mind that nursing isn't just about the medical knowledge that you will acquire in the years you may work as a nurse. It is so much more. It is instead setting aside your personal views and delivering the best care you know and never passing judgment to those that you will be taking care of. Each and every one of you have chosen this particular field for a very special reason. Never forget those reasons, especially during the long hour shifts that some of you may work. Whatever it is that has brought you into this career path, I want you to always keep in mind that before you enter each one of your patients' rooms, that this person you may have not known prior to the start of your shift is someone's grandmother, grandfather, mother, father, sister, brother, and neighbor. And one day, we may be the person on the other end receiving the care which we have chosen to give today. So as we give this care, whether it be a bed bath or hand them their medication before bedtime, we must always give them the care and attention we all deserve. With that being said, I want to thank our wonderful faculty and staff, for it is them that have guided each and every one of you through this amazing new chapter in your life. On behalf of Angel Technical Institute Nursing School, I want to wish you all the best and thank you for allowing us to be a part of your journey. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna let Ms. Maria Garcia come up and she's gonna have a commencement speech prior to the ceremony's beginning, where we're gonna start calling out the students that have done honors and high honors and so on and so forth. Come on, Maria.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to thank my family and friends for joining me on a very special day. This has been a very long journey for both myself and my family. This long journey has taught me that there is nothing in life that will stop me from succeeding or achieving my goals. I would like to dedicate this diploma and honor to my father. I will forever and always keep his last words in my heart that will follow me forever. Mi hija, tú eres chingona y tú puedes. And he was absolutely right. His words always inspired me to strive for the best. Never did he doubt me. He picked me up when I was down. I couldn't have had asked for more. He was absolutely the best role model in my life. I couldn't have had done it without the support of my husband and my son. They sacrificed every second of my career with me. I stand here today in front of all of you with a special message. Never give up is the key to success. Anything is possible. Thank you.
Now we're gonna have Ms. Martha Lester come up and give us the speech on the history of nurses tending.
Hello, everyone. The history of nursing penning. The penning ceremony is a time-honored nursing school tradition. Other, often more personally meaningful than the graduation ceremony, it signifies your official initiation into the brotherhood and sisterhood of nurses. The ceremony is rich with symbolism. The history of this rite of passage can be traced all the way back to the Crusades of the 12th century. During this time, the Knights of the Order of the Hospital of St. John the Baptist tended to the injured and infirm crusaders. When new monks were initiated into the order, they vowed to serve the sick soldiers in a ceremony where each monk was given a Maltese cross, the first badges given to those who were nurses. The modern ceremony dates back to 1860s when Florence Nightingale was awarded the Red Cross of St. George in recognition for her tireless service to the injured during the Crimean War. To share the honor, she, in turn, presented a Medal of Excellence to her brightest graduates. By 1916, the practice of pinning new graduates was standard throughout the United States. Nursing pins are traditionally presented to the newly graduated nurses by the faculty during the pinning ceremony as a symbolic welcome into the profession of nursing. Graduates, wear your pins with pride. You deserve it.
And now we're going to go ahead and start on the presentation of awards. And I'm going to present them. Unfortunately, our Dean of Nursing is out sick today, so she wasn't able to make it. But we will go ahead and we will start with those students that they got a 3.0 and up to 3.4. Okay, so give me 1 minute, let me get my list down. So our honor students are Ms. Alonzo Mercedes. Yes. Next is Miss Sarah Braffy. Hannah Garrison. Ms. Linda Phillip. Our high honor students are those students that had a 3.5 and higher GPA. That's going to be Ms. Gail Burke. Wrong, but Ms. Ludi Dorvilla. Doralis Lechuga. And Mr. Eric Pace. Carmen Villarreal. presentation of diplomas. Once we start the presentation of diplomas, you're going to start with Dr. Sanchez. He's going to hand you your diploma. You're going to go down and shake everybody's hand. And Ms. Rochelle is going to pin each one of you guys, okay? So here we go. Hopefully, I know there are some students that didn't come in. So if they didn't come in, then we will go ahead and skip over them, okay?
Here.
needs music with that kind of a voice, right? That was beautiful. Thank you. Okay, so now we're going to do the presentation of diplomas. And I'm going to call each one of you guys in alphabetical order. And as you come up, if you have not yet been pinned, Dr. Sanchez will hand you your diploma, and you will shake the instructor's hand, and Ms. Rochelle will pin you. Okay, if you've already been pinned, then you guys can go ahead and come back and have a seat again. Now, if I'm missing somebody here that's not on my list, we're just going to go over them and continue on, okay? So first, we're going to have Ms. Protege Agastade. Mercedes Alonso. Rosa Amparo de Juliet. Sorry. Sarah Bradby. Willen Brutus. Ms. Gail Burke. Justin Census. Betsaida Dunny. Ludi Darvilla. Jolianne Esperance. Maria Garcia. Gregory Hoffer. Doralis Lechuga. Linda Morales.
Yeah.
and Ms. Helen James.
Last few words. Being a nurse means You will never be bored. You will always be frustrated. You will be surrounded by challenges. So much to do and so little time. You will carry immense responsibility and very little authority. You will step into people's lives and you will make a difference. Some will bless you, some will curse you. You will see people at their worst and at their best. You will see life begin and end. You will cry a lot. You will laugh a lot. You will know what it is to be human and what it is to be humane. But through it all, you will have the most rewarding job in the world. And no matter how difficult the days may get, never forget the reason you became a nurse. Thank you all for joining us in this special evening.
Final exam and through the hard work they're going to do and the field that will work out. We love you for who you are. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name I pray you.
Amen.
You can't survive. So when you feel like home,
Say welcome home, 'cause honey, nothing, nothing, nothing can ever change this love I have for you. Oh, 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 nothing.